Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Command Conquer Red Alert 3 Uprising, and we're onto the last mini campaign, The Tale of Yuriku. Guide the Empire of the Rising Sun's vengeful psionic commander through the piece together chronicles of a troubled, bloodstained past. So this campaign will be a little special as we only really control one hero unit and, well, need to navigate ourselves to a number of labyrinths. And, well, let's watch the cutscene.
Tonight, for our special report, Brenda Snow is here with an exclusive on the powerful and elusive Yuriko Omega. Brenda?
Thanks, Ted. By now, you may have heard the stories of Yuriko Omega, the mysterious Japanese girl with the terrifying psionic powers. During the war, Allied soldiers claimed that she decimated entire combat battalions using only her mind. Who is this young girl? Where did she come from? And how did she develop these fearsome and fantastic abilities? Yuriko's history is somewhat murky. Some sources say that her real name is Yuriko Matsui, and that Omega is simply a code name used by the military. According to these same sources, she was born in the small coastal town of Tanabe and exhibited paranormal powers from the time she was very young. There are indications that she was scorned by her schoolmates because of her unique abilities. When the government learned of these talents, she was taken away to the Shiro Psychic Research Center, run by this man, Dr. Shinji Shimada. He's widely known for his advances in the area of psionic research. What did the scientists at the Shiro Research Center do to this confused, lonely little girl? We may never know exactly, but whatever it was, she was never the same again.
So, somewhere in the arteries of the vast Imperial research facility, an unusual young woman awakens from a long and terrible slumber fraught with nightmares she knows were real. So, we have to break out of the facility, basically. And, well, I will be playing on hard, and let's go.
Yuriko, wake up. You must break free of this place. I am Izumi, your sister. You must listen to me. You can be more powerful than you can imagine, Yuriko. Use your powers and develop them, and more powers will come. Discover yourself.
So we are basically vision locked to Yuriko. We can't scroll around, which will be quite annoying, to be honest. And we simply move with left or the right mouse button, so we can basically choose which one. We have an ability, a psychokinetic burst, and well, it disintegrates bodies and short circuits machines in an explosion of raw psychokinetic energy. And well, we can kill infantry with it, stun vehicles, and
I
it has a cooldown.
Psychokinetic burst.
So basically just this.
And then this. After the psychic domination talent, everyone in this facility started being much nicer to me.
Can access new abilities through these terminals.
Their minds are weak. You can lure them over to fight for you.
And the next ability allows us to take over some enemy units.
Yes.
We are only limited to 3. And of course she can attack just like in the normal campaign with lifting stuff in the air.
I see you've been snooping in the computers. Clever girl, Yuriko. I am Dr. Shimada. You must not leave yet. It is too dangerous.
Turn back, Yuriko. You're going to get hurt.
Okay, let me just... Okay, yes, I can look at the map here. So, there was actually a little dead end at the other side, which I do want to explore. As there are often terminals in there which enhance my abilities. Nothing here. Oh, Also, you are not one-shotted by shinobis. So, well, we at least got that. Single vehicle shouldn't be a big deal. I would just love to be able to move the camera around freely. I know it's a hero mission and you only got one unit, but free camera movement and especially a mini map are just so essential things. And we are also very zoomed in.
This is test data from my psionic shield training. If they didn't expect I could reflect live ammunition back at them, they shouldn't have shot at me.
So basically, this is a deflect shield.
It will reflect their weapons back at them.
Well, we don't actually need this for these two. Okay, I just need to look where am I all the time, so, well. I would love to have a little mini-map up there. Okay, we are basically invulnerable during this phase. And we also deflect the bullets back up then. Stun the vehicles.
I'm injured. I need to find a trauma station.
Yes, we should get back to one, just to heal up. Good. That's better. We'll also do a little save, just to be sure. As well, these missions can very quickly go south. That shield is just so helpful. Was there something in the corner? Okay, no problem. Good. Ah, here's a little indoor war factory. Should quickly destroy these.
They trained me to move heavy objects with my mind. There are dozens of accident reports blamed on my so-called psionic slam.
So, with this...
objects, tear this place apart.
First I lift them, then I throw them.
Yes, we can basically lift objects with that ability and throw them. So from now on, a bunch of tanks will be a much less scarier thing. Just reflect all the damage back.
I need to find a way to clear away all that junk.
we've got
yes.
something for that.
Soon you will be free.
Send in the steel Ronin.
Yes, the steel Ronin who are not effective against infantry. Where do I need to go? Up left first. Yes. No more spawns from this area. Don't know why they are sending steel Ronins. It's one of the most least effective units they could send. Move that out of the way. That stool is blocking me. Chair! Blah. Already switching into German again. Hop. Think this one was. Yes, we go around here, there are probably more spawners and stuff. Again, more steel Ronins. Melee anti-tank units are just the thing you need against the Psionic Commando. How is the map looking? We need to just... yes, this thing to the bottom right, and also this guy should be eliminated. Is there anything in here? Oh, that was just the way we came from. Archer mains actually do quite a bit of damage. We've got another console.
Each time I learn about myself from one of these data terminals, I regain some of the power that my captors have been trying to suppress.
Okay, and now we get ability points with each new console, so we can upgrade our speed here, upgrade our health, but I do want to upgrade our attack power here first.
You're more than they can handle now. Find your way out. Find your way to freedom.
Now, I just need to get out of here.
Troops, seize the girl. Put her back in the cell.
Why isn't the first action just shut down all of those health stations? Those are mine now.
Nanoport is endangered! Unfurl them!
Come on, destroy the cores. Also, what's up with all of those dragonflies here? Okay. That thing seems to be bugged. Well, it doesn't matter.
And of course, storage has been compromised.
Only two are not a big deal. So I think down here, are we exactly? Yes, down here is another dead end, which is probably another console that we can take. Yes. Let's go back a little bit. That was a bit close.
So this is one of Dr. Shimada's data terminals. Nothing but dirty pictures and mahjong games.
Let's upgrade health next. I really wish I had a minimap.
Yuriko, please! Stop! I cannot allow you to leave like this. I know you are confused. I can explain everything.
Oh, you are still not done. We must go.
Please don't do this. We're not trying to hurt you. We're trying to help you.
Of course. So where am I again? Down here. There should be another console up and to the right. Having a few shinobis is just such an improvement of a force here. But okay, this wasn't another console. Where is the third one? Is it in this corridor?
Troops, seize the girl. Put her back in her cell.
No. That isn't it. Only a lot of tanks. Well, or rather tengus. don't know where the last console is, but well, it will show itself, hopefully. Have a few more shinobis. Oop, I don't know if you saw that, but that was a bit of black screen in there. I hope that won't be too frequent. Doesn't appear in the normal game. Just in this little mini campaign.
Be careful with her, you are food! I said contain her, don't kill her!
I don't know, but it seems fine for now. Just get rid of these war factories. Get rid of the King Onis. Should be more war factories up ahead. That's a reflection up now. Should be able to engage the turret. Oh! Okay, we can lift those explosive barrels as well. The turret down here. Okay, we are locked in, so maybe that other console was the other hallway, but well, we don't really need it. We should be fine.
We've got you! Don't struggle! We have you surrounded! On order of the Emperor, you are under arrest!
I'm sorry, Yuriko. It was the only way. Why did you have to turn against me? There was nothing else I could do.
Why didn't you do that the first time? If it's that easy...
Welcome back to our special report on Yuriko Omega. During the war, Yuriko was used by the Empire's military machine. Her psionic powers made her one of the most dangerous weapons in the Empire's arsenal. Her reign of terror ended when the Allied forces invaded Tokyo. Yuriko was found unconscious under the rubble of the Imperial Palace and taken into custody. Transported back to the West, she was kept in complete isolation in a high-security compound deep in the jungles of Guam.
It seems like it just sends us right into the next mission, so well. Then I'll use this as a parting point between videos. So next time, the second mission of this little campaign here. And well, it has some flaws and I don't know what that black screen at one point was all about, but well. We will see. Until then, have a nice day.